Hello everyone, my name is Father Law, and today I've got for you my guide for Jiang Jun. At the time of making this video, I currently have 42 reps in him after playing every single mode with him extensively. I will break this video down between his moveset, max punishes, duels, and 4v4 modes, along with sharing my personal setup for perks and feats. The goal of this video is to provide what I feel to be a good start for anyone wishing to learn or perhaps take this character to the next level. I will leave timestamps in a pinned comment down below in case you only play or wish to learn one mode specifically. If you do not know much about the character, I highly suggest watching the video in its entirety, and if you consider yourself to be a more advanced Jiang Jun player, stick around because I do have a few neat tricks that I've picked up in my experience. If you like the video, please like and subscribe. Alright, so first things first, I'm going to run through Jiang Jun's moveset. If you already have an in-depth understanding, or at the very least, know all of his moves, feel free to skip ahead in the video with one of the timestamps that I leave down below to the part in which you would like to learn. Now, if you do not know his moveset or you're new to the character, then it is very important that you start with the very basics, which are the moveset. The first attack in Jiang Jun's moveset is called Scheming Wind. It is a light chain. Simply press light 2 times to use this chain. It is important to note that the second light in any of Jiang Jun's chains, including this one, can be delayed significantly to make it appear faster than what it really is. Normally it is 500 milliseconds, and you can delay this significantly to make it much harder for your opponent to block, parry, and punish you for using. Next up, we have Tough Discipline, which is a light heavy chain. Any heavy finisher that Jiang Jun has is an unblockable. Up next, we have Rigorous Sway, which is the opposite. It is a heavy light chain. And just like your Scheming Wind, your finisher light can be delayed, and you should always delay it. Next, we have Sweep 1000, which is a double heavy chain, which again leads to the unblockable heavy. Now we will be doing the twofold slash, which is Jiang Jun's out of lock attack when running. This attack can be feinted after the first hit if you hit the feint button. For his regular zone attack, just simply press light and heavy at the same time to perform his wide range zone attack. This can be followed up with either a light or an unblockable heavy. After a parry, you can zone to use his Daoshi Swirl, which is his zone attack after a parry. It is unblockable and it has quite a lot of range, which will hit not only your opponent, but any enemies that may be around you in a ganking situation. Next up, we have Mighty Sanction. To perform this move, you simply dodge forward and press heavy. This move can be hard feinted or it can be soft feinted into a shin kick. The shin kick confirms a light attack and can chain into a heavy. You are not locked into throwing the light in any direction, so be sure to always change the direction in which you are throwing the lights, so that way if they do dodge, it is not an easy light parry for your opponent. Keep in mind that you are also not locked into throwing the light. You can also mix up with a heavy attack to throw off parry timings and maybe hit them with a higher damaging move. The unblockable is also guaranteed if you shin kick them into a wall. His last move in his moveset is Mighty Backlash. To perform this move, simply dodge to the left or right of your opponent and press the heavy button. You will perform a dodge attack, and it does have really good invincibility frames, which means it will be hard, or just rare, for you to be smacked out of it. Like Mighty Sanction, This move allows you to either hard feint it, or you can simply press the light attack button to soft feint it into a 400 millisecond light attack. Whether or not you let it fly or you soft feint to the light attack, you can still finish either chain with a heavy or a light. Okay, so the last part of Jiang's moveset that I feel is important to talk about is his Sifu pose. His Sifu pose can allow him to regenerate stamina after basically any attack. He can go back into it. He can even feint any of his heavies, regular or unblockable, back into it. So if you ever need stamina, this is a good way to make space and get some stamina back. Like Nabushi's hidden stance, Jiang Jun's Sifu pose has invincibility frames, allowing him to use it as a dodge on attacks. Against attacks with longer recovery, such as heavy attacks with no fast follow-up, he can attempt to punish it with a zone attack. Okay, so moving on from his moveset, we are going to be heading into his max punishes. Regardless of what level you currently play at, max punishes are a vital component to learning the kit of any character, Jiang Jun especially. Jiang has some of the best punishes in the game, so it is vital that you learn these as soon as possible. The sooner you get these into your muscle memory, the better that you will be when using this character. It is important for many reasons, and the main one being that his punishes are easily the strongest part of his character as a whole. Okay, so to begin with, off of a guard break, you get a zone attack. You can then follow this up with either a light or an unblockable heavy. If you guard break someone near a wall, throw them straight forward into the wall for a 37 damage top heavy. Keep in mind that if you are too close to the wall, they can block or parry it. If they are far enough away from the wall, you can also go for the shin kick. Simply throw them into the wall, dodge forward, and do your shin kick to kick them back into the wall, which will confirm your top heavy unblockable. This does one more damage and a slight amount of stamina drain to your opponent. However, your opponent can still often dodge the kick if you are too close, making the top heavy far more reliable for a mere one less damage, along with being able to use it when closer to the wall, unlike the shin kick. For these reasons, I always go for the top heavy. Off of a heavy parry, do a zone attack for 25 damage. Off of a light parry, perform a top heavy for 37 damage. If you perform a heavy or light parry in front of a wall, use the choke, as this will grant you 5 slap damage, along with granting you a top heavy for a total of 42 damage. Hold down your guard break for a longer choke with slightly more stamina drain, or press your guard break instantly and release it for a quicker choke with slightly less stamina drain. When parrying an out of stamina opponent, do a choke followed by a zone attack into a top unblockable for a total of 68 damage. It is important to buffer the input of the zone immediately after the choke, as mistiming this can result in your unblockable being parryable. A good trick I've learned for this is if the zone hits as soon as they are landing on the ground, you've done it correctly and are safe to follow through with the top unblockable. When grabbing an opponent that is out of stamina, throw them forward and do 2 top heavies for a total of 75 damage. One thing to note against reflex guard heroes is that any parry can confirm the choke into an immediate zone attack for 30 damage. Static guard heroes can block the follow-up zone by moving their guard in that direction preemptively, making the punish for them just a simple zone attack. There are a lot of punishes, and it may seem like a lot to remember, but it is very important to learn these, as they will eventually become muscle memory and maximize the amount of damage that you can do to your opponents for making a mistake, as this is Jing Jin's strongest attribute. It will become your most useful tool in any one-on-one or 1v1 scenario. Next up, I'm going to explain his strengths in 4v4 modes. For starters, we'll discuss his feats. I personally like to use Quick Revive, Revenge Attacks, Tough as Nails, and Fire Flask. I choose Quick Revive as my tier 1 because in group fights, especially in Breach mode, reviving an ally can quickly turn a fight around and save you respawn tickets. This feat alone makes Jiang a great support character right off the bat. I chose my tier 2 feat as Revenge Attacks because getting revenge while you're attacking really helps when you're fighting against unorganized groups of people. So if you're able to parry and attack, you can continuously build towards getting revenge, and sometimes just getting that extra revenge, just popping that off, can really turn a fight around, and it's very nice to have. Although this one could definitely be interchangeable with Inspire. It depends on your playstyle. If you are more confident in yourself, go for Revenge Attacks. If you think you need a boost in teamfights, go for Inspire. His last tier 2 feat is Benefaction, which regenerates stamina for your teammates around you as long as you're in Sifu pose, but in a team fight, you shouldn't be sitting in the pose for very long. I believe it's more important to stay in the fight, which is why I would never choose this feat over the other two. For tier 3, I've chosen Tough as Nails. This adds on to my tanky, hard-to-kill build for Jiang. Having a higher health bar at all times, I feel is better than Second Wind, as you always will have this extra health bar, and you don't have to be vulnerable at all to have this extra health during a fight like you would having to use Second Wind. Soothing Mist just received a nerf not too long ago, reducing its effectiveness, so again, I would prefer just to have myself a larger, tankier health bar for the entire game. For Tier 4, I simply use the Fire Flask. It can be used to disrupt a group fight and clear minions or pikemen really quickly if needed. And for these reasons, I personally feel like it's the most flexible Tier 4 feat, which is why I use it. So, along with the feats I use, I use the three perks, Vengeful Barrier, Bulk Up, and Bastion. Bastion offers a 10% damage reduction while on a zone or carrying a banner. Bulk Up adds 4 health to your health bar for every renown level you get in-game, totaling to 16 extra health when you get to your 4th renown level. Vengeful Barrier grants a 25 damage shield every time you exit revenge mode. These perks solidify my specific Jiang Jun build. It makes him incredibly tanky, very hard to kill. You could be, when you're on a zone, they're going to have to do over 210-ish damage to you. This is not including the 25 damage shield you get every time you go into revenge. So this build alone makes Jiang very hard to kill. If it makes him very, like a competent Jiang Jun, very, very hard to kill. So I'm not exactly sure what level you can obtain these perks, but I do know that the absolute latest that you can get them is at Rep 7 with Legendary Gear. One thing that's often overlooked whenever talking about 4v4 modes are the executions used during them. I personally always make sure to have equipped Keep Your Stance Wide and Stay Down, as Keep Your Stance Wide is very quick and a good way to get a small amount of health back quickly, and Stay Down gives a lot of health very quickly into the execution. However, it does keep you trapped in the animation a little bit longer, but in exchange for that, you're getting a lot more health. So I like to keep both of them because I can get health back quickly, depending on the situation. It's just nice to have. Overall, I believe that this build is really strong and supportive for any playstyle you may want in 4v4s. You can keep your team up and running, you can provide long distractions against the opposing team, and overall improvements to your odds of winning 1v1 scenarios. And overall, it just allows you to make a lot more mistakes and avoid getting instantly killed in ganks, which we all find annoying. Jiang's easy access to unblockables allows him to provide really easy pressure when ganking. So, if your opponent is not looking at you and they're looking at your ally, you can pretty much just whiff a light into unblockable, throw a heavy into unblockable, zone into unblockable, anything, and you are immediately putting unblockable pressure on that person. You can feint it, you know, if you're organized with the teammate, you know, you could feint it, they could guard break, you know, whatever. You can get really creative with it, but it does create almost instant pressure in a lot of scenarios. So it is a very useful tool, and you should use it as such, especially in 4v4 modes. When anti-ganking with it, try to switch your log onto the farthest opponent away from you and swing in the direction the teammates are in, as they will become unparryable to whoever is not, or to whoever you are not locked onto. This is similar to Raider's zone. Overall, his zone attack has a really wide hitbox, allowing him to hit multiple enemies surrounding him, which is great to use in general and after parries. On to Duels. I don't have a ton to say about him for this game mode, as at higher levels of play, most of his offense is entirely shut down by dodging early or dodging backwards. Because of this, it is considered that he does not really have great offense or any reliable opener. However, if you do not have an opponent that does either of these things, your main openers are going to be your unblockable heavies and your shin kick. Feinting your dodge forward heavy is going to be your best bet at out of stamina pressure. If they try to dodge the kick early and you feint a guard break, you can throw them forward to get your max punish of two top heavies. The shin kick is also useful for opening up people that do not know that it can be dodged in a single timing. So you can either feint to guard break if they try to dodge the kick early, or you can let the shin kick go if they don't dodge thinking you're going to go for the guard break. Another thing to note about his shin kick, and I've seen many people make this mistake of missing the shin kick and then continuing on with a top light. You are not at all limited to throwing a top light after the shin kick. You can throw a light from any direction, or even throw an unblockable that will hit if they parry on a light timing. A neat trick I've learned when using the shin kick is to follow up with a right side light after it, as from your opponent's viewpoint, their character's body covers up the animation and a bit of the block indicator, making it, I would say, harder to block, parry, and just, you know, be aware of other than the top light or the light from the left side from your angle. If you throw your second light and your opponent dodges, do not go into Sifu, as you will be guard broken regardless of the range. Only go into Sifu if they do a dodge attack after dodging your second light. After landing a light attack, throwing a max delayed second light can be punished by an opponent dodging and guard breaking. Throwing an undelayed second light after landing your first can't be guard broken, but runs the risk of being much more parryable and reactable in general. If you whiff your first light, regardless of the time in which you delay the second one, it is always a confirmed guard break on dodge. After landing a heavy, the hit stun prevents your follow-up light from being dodged if it is undelayed. However, if it is delayed, it becomes dodgeable but not guard break vulnerable, making it only vulnerable to dodge attacks. This works the same way regardless of whether the heavy lands or is blocked. His zone attacks work the same way as the heavies, and his unblockable heavy finishers, if dodged, always confirm a guard break. Knowing these weaknesses are extremely useful for knowing when it is safe and unsafe depending on your opponent's character and how your opponent decides to play them. For example, an opponent that dodges a lot is one to be wary of. A character like Scent or Raider, who rely on a lot of guard breaks, you have to be careful what attacks you throw. In Duels, the strongest part of Jiang Jun is his health pool. Do not give up or feel overwhelmed if you get hit by a certain attack a lot, as you only need a single punish to level the playing field damage-wise. You can afford to be hit a lot by your opponent's attacks, whereas they cannot afford to be hit a lot by yours. Take note of exactly what they do. The more they attack, the more likely they will fall into a sort of repetition, or from there you could figure out what they prioritize and make decisions from there. The more often they attack, the more opportunities you have to make reads and punish them for more damage than what they could do to you. One of the best ways to avoid neutral offense is to take advantage of Jiang's long range and his feintable dodge attack. Try to bait your opponents into chasing you and attempt to trip them up into making mistakes. This is a great way to counter characters that have very good neutral pressure up close, such as Black Prior, Berserker, Warden, those types of characters. Whereas if you're far away, the shield bashes, the shoulder bashes, the feints, they're not going to reach you. And if you can bait them into going towards you, you can actually punish them, or you can go on the offense if they run themselves out of stamina trying to chase you. So doing this is a very effective strategy against characters to which you will not be able to fight a straight up engagement with. That's all I have today for my guide on Jiang Jun. If it helped you, feel free to share it with anyone you know, and feel free to leave any questions you may have in the comment section below. I will answer them to the best of my knowledge as soon as possible. Special thanks to my friends in the video for helping me test stuff out for hours at a time. I have a few more videos I plan to come out with that won't take nearly as long as this one, so if you enjoyed, stay tuned for more, and until next time, goodbye.